Adam Klitschka. I'm 20 and I'm flying for Czech Republic.
Hi, I'm Nikola Klitschka. I'm 23 and I'm from the Czech Republic as well.
So I think you two are our only brother and sister combination flying here. How is that for you, flying with your sibling?
It's very nice. We can cooperate, discuss stuff before the flight.
Same with the whole Czech team. We've known each other since we were like little kids, so it all feels like one big family.
And is there much rivalry between you two, or is it, are you happy when you see the other one doing well, or if you beat them?
I guess a little bit of rivalry, but...
Well, now I think I'm just behind you. Like that. We're kind of neck and neck. Now it's becoming more of a rivalry.
How do you find this week here in Grudziądz?
Very nice. Like, we so far, no flight has been cancelled. The weather has been amazing. The task has been very good. I love it.
The organization of everything has been just incredible. Brad is amazing with the weather. He's just, like, I think the best meteorologist we've had in a competition by far, because he's just, I don't know, him being a pilot just changes everything.
Good luck to both of you. We look forward to seeing out who comes out on top, but good luck and enjoy the remaining flights.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Welcome to episode 6, our final episode here at the 6th FAI World Hot Air Balloon Junior Championships in Grudziądz. We've got a common launch point this evening. The weather is looking fine, so we will get another flight. So the common launch point means that the event organisers have decided a launch point for all the competitors to take off from. So we're going to get a great spectacle here this evening with 45 balloons all taking off together, which is going to be fantastic. We've got three tasks. We've got a pilot declared goal. We've then got a land run, which is a little bit different from the land run we saw earlier in the week. We'll get into that more later. And then we finish off with a hesitation waltz. We've got four pilots that have got a chance to win this, really. They are Jakub Jezak from Poland, Martin Delier-Snyder from Belgium, Daniel Gregory from the United Kingdom, and Paul Cuneau from France. The green flag has just gone up, the balloons are starting to inflate around me, now we just enjoy the show. Well, the last evening flight here in Grugence did not disappoint. We saw fantastic approaches from many pilots, including most of the leaders, Martin Delir, Snyder, Jakub Jezak and Dan Gregory, all providing brilliant answers to each other. It was a pleasure to watch them. So I'll just explain a little bit about how that land run task worked. We'll get the overlay up again. So the one before, earlier in the week, was all about speed. You had a set time to do it. You had to make the biggest triangle. With this task, you still have to make the biggest triangle, but the land run tonight, you had a circle that was 4 kilometres across, and you were having to declare that circle yourself and then fly your land run triangle track, getting 3 points within that circle to make as big an area as possible.
Left hand down a bit.
Am I doing anything?
No.
I think we need
to turn around. A little bit of camaraderie is not
going to
sort
this
out.
When most of the teams went to bed last night, they might have been thinking there's very low chance of us flying, but the weather has turned out for the better and it looks like we're going to get another nice flight in this morning, albeit with a little bit more wind speed. The top four are the same, however the order has changed after yesterday evening's flight. Daniel Gregory from the United Kingdom is now in the lead after a very strong flight yesterday evening. Jakub Jezak from Poland is in second and Paul Cuneau from France in third, with Martin Delir Snyder from Belgium in fourth. The gap between all four of them though is only about 500 points, which is very small. That can all be won and lost in one single task, and this morning we have four tasks. We have a pilot declared goal, a minimum distance double drop, a maximum distance time, and then a fly on to finish the last flight of the championship. So there have now been a couple of changes to the task sheet. Its minimum distance double drop has now changed to a Gordon Bennett Memorial, which means instead of dropping two markers, you're just trying to drop one marker in one of the scoring areas as close as possible to the centre of the target. Also, the maximum distance time has been cancelled, so it's just three tasks now to decide a junior world championship. Brad, why are we flying this morning?
Well, we got lucky, is what it came down to. So around a low, there's several different disturbances that kind of rotate counterclockwise, at least in the northern hemisphere, and we are in between different waves right now. So the first wave moved through overnight, resulted in some scattered thunderstorms, especially north. That wave has now moved out. We're waiting for the next wave to move in, so we're kind of in an opportunity window, and so we're getting the chance to fly yet again this morning, the ninth flight. We'll be right back.
unfortunately for Dan Gregory on this task, he was just outside the scoring area on the road. Paul Canoe, also with an okay drop, but quite far out. It was Martin de Leer Snyder from Belgium and Jakub Jezak from Poland that both came in with excellent approaches and will have very, very good scores.
Final results have been verified and are valid.
Number 5, Kenyan decane from Belgium. Number 4, also from Belgium, Martin Dier Snyder. From United Thank you.
Dan Gregory, third place at the Junior Worlds. How does that feel?
Really, really good. I'm so happy. Just want to enjoy myself and have good fun and probably just do myself proud, really, and also like my brother proud, I think, because I just want to come out here and do as well as I could, because it's just hard, because a lot of these people you never really compete against. 17 countries from all around the world, 45 pilots all trying to strive to be the best.
How did you manage to stay focused and stay strong throughout the competition?
Well, I actually listened to you, Dom, at the beginning of the week, I think. Told everyone to make sure that they rest there, and not just, it's a marathon, not a sprint, really. And I think that's sort of how I sort of approach it. And if you sort of look at my results and like how I got on, I started the week really, really slowly, and I sort of picked up the pace going through the end of the week. And I think the last couple of days, my average was probably about 770.
It looked like you brought you saved your last flight, your best flying for the last flights.
Yeah, and I mean, I probably the best flight of my life, and I was ecstatic going over that last target last night.
And a lot of those emotions from the week overflowed on stage.
Tiredness and like emotionally drained as well, and mentally drained and physically drained, I think it was. Obviously, emotions ran high because I had a photo of my brother with me on the stage, and he'd have been here, he'd probably been on a higher step than me if he could have been here, I'm sure. And I'm sure he'd really be proud of me and where I am, and I wish he was just here to sort of celebrate this evening.
Enjoy tonight, enjoy your celebrations, congratulations.
Oh, well.
We're all very
Cheers,
proud.
Thanks, Thank
mate.
You.
So Paul Cunneau, second place at the Junior World Championships. How does that feel?
It's amazing. I didn't realize right now, but it's just incredible. I have a fantastic team, French team is amazing, so yeah.
And it was a really long, exhausting competition, but you were always near the top. How was it for you emotionally in the week?
Yeah, very long week, 9 flights, more than 40 tasks. It was very long, but and always in the top 5. It was the first time for me to do all the competition on the top. So for the last flight, I was a little bit stressed, but yeah. Very good result at the end, so very happy. Yeah.
Great result. Well done, Paul, and we will look for you in the future.
Thank you.
Jakub Jezak, you are the 2023 Junior World Hot Air Ballooning Champion. How does that feel?
I don't know. I don't believe it. Yeah, I need some time to believe it.
It really was a great team effort, and it will take a little while to sink in, so just enjoy this moment. Yeah. It was a really long and exhausting competition. So many flights, so many tasks. Yeah. How did you stay focused and stay believing even when you sometimes were leading, sometimes not leading?
I'm not sure that I'm staying still time focused. That was really nervous when I was on first place. It was not easy to think directly about flight, but in this moment when I start, this bad feeling staying at the down and the earth, and there when I can focus on this flight.
So when you take off, that's when you feel you're just focused in on the flying?
Yeah, when I start, I'm feeling better, and yeah.
Amazing.
Yes, I'm flying better.
I think everyone gets nervous before then. Jakub, thank you very much. Congratulations. Well done.
Thanks.
Enjoy.
Thanks.
So there we have it. After 9 flights and 40 tasks, the 6th FAI Junior World Hot Air Ballooning Championships has come to an end. Jakub Jezak from Poland is our new Junior World Champion. He really did fly amazing all week, and all of the top finishers really showed a lot of consistency across a lot of different conditions. It has been a pleasure bringing you this coverage from myself and all the team back home. Thank you very much, everyone, for watching, and hope to see you again wherever the next event is. Thank you very much. Goodbye for now.